Yeah, hi guys, I'm back. So what I'm going to do is now I'm going to tell you about this background. The National Awakening also grew out of an intellectual reaction to the Enlightenment that emphasized national identity and developed a romantic view of cultural expression through nationhood. Now, the National Awakening also grew out of an intellectual reaction to the Enlightenment that emphasized national identity and developed a romantic view of cultural self-expression through nationhood. When did this happen? 1848, or it must have happened a bit before that. Okay, so the French Revolution is actually 1789, and the nationalism started in 1848. It created then. So I'm just going through this background. Actually, what happened? So the nation started awakening. You know, they became more frequent. They came to know about things and they wanted a change. So also grew out an intellectual reaction to the Enlightenment. Now, what was the Enlightenment? The Enlightenment is the age of Enlightenment was an intellectual and philosophical movement that dominated the world of ideas in Europe during the 17th and the 19th centuries. So people always want a change. We also want a change now. If we want to compare India with during that time, if we go and see the Sultanate and during the Mughal time also, we always wanted a change. It happens also with the Congress, it happens with the BJP, it happens with everyone. There's history all over. So every time we are wanting something change, because when we don't like something, we always want a revolution, you know. We react to it. We don't think what is good. Whatever we think, the revolutionists think that that is good, and the people against them think that is whatever they are doing is that's good. So that becomes generally, and it creates into history as time goes by. So what happened yesterday is already history today. Okay, so National Awakening also grew out of an intellectual reaction to the Enlightenment. The Enlightenment, as I said, was an intellectual and philosophical movement that dominated the world of ideas in Europe during 17th and the 19th centuries, that emphasized national identity. Now, national identity is a person's identity or sense of belonging to one state or to one nation. It is the sense of a nation as a cohesive whole, as represented by distinctive traditions, culture, and language. National identity may refer to the subjective feeling one shares with a group of people. Okay, so this is what happened. Like, we want to say this is India, we are Hindustan, we have this culture in us, we cannot change it, we want this whole country to follow this culture and language. So this was a revolution, but we can't have it. We are a linguistic country with so many languages, so many cultures, and that's why we are a democratic republic country. Okay, that time it was under the monarchy, and they were wanting this thing to overturn and change, and developed a romantic view of cultural expression through nationhood. A nation is, as you know, it's a stable community of people formed on the basis of a common language, right? Territory, history, ethnicity, or psychological makeup manifested in a common culture. A nation is more, what do you say, a nation is more overly political than an ethnic group. It has been described as a fully mobilized or institutionalized ethnic group. You got my point? Now, what happened is the National Awakening also grew out of an intellectual reaction to the Enlightenment. So they were intellectual people through philosophy and culture. They were trying to get this thing changed and to have this national identity. This is my country. I wanted to this happen, and we all get together. We are going to solve this. We are going to have this culture. We are going to have this language. It was a romantic view of cultural expression. There was no gunfight and all, but that happened later. Okay, through a nationhood. Nationhood means total, a community, stable community of people formed on the basis of a common language, territory. I mean, common language, territory, history, ethnicity, or psychological makeup manifested, rather manifested in a common culture. A nation is more into political than ethnic group. Ethnic is again culture and philosophical. Okay, and what do you say? It had been described as a fully mobilized or institutionalized ethnic group. You know, they were into, they were had, they were having brains. The key exponent of the modern idea of the nation state was the German G.W. Friedrich Hegel. He was a German philosopher and an important figure of German idealism. He achieved recognition in his day, and while primarily influencing the continental tradition of philosophy, has become increasingly influential during that time. The French Revolution. Now we come to that part. In the background, the French Revolution is there. What was French Revolution? The French Revolution was a period of far-reaching social and political upheaval in France and its colonies, beginning in 1789 and ending in 1799. Including during that time, Napoleon Bonaparte was also there. The revolution overthrew the monarchy, established a republic, catalyzed violent periods of political turmoil, and finally culminated to a dictatorship under Napoleon Bonaparte. They came under dictatorship. This is what happened. So that's why there was huge turmoil. They were wanting to change this monarchy. Then they wanted to get it democratic. They wanted to have that nationhood thing together. They wanted to have that enlightenment to this national identity with this nationhood. And that time this French Revolution happened and it broke down again. Huge political turmoil. They went back to dictatorship. Although primarily a republican revolution. What is a republican revolution? A republican mechanism is a representative form of government organization. It is a political ideology centered on citizenship in a state organized as a republic. If we go into history, it ranges from the rule of a representative minority or oligarchy to popular sovereignty. It has different definitions and interpretations regarding in which place it is used. So the French Revolution, although primarily a republican revolution, initiated a movement towards the modern Napoleon and the Napoleon Code as an instrument for the political transformation of Europe. What am I saying? What happened is the French Revolution, although primarily a republican revolution, initiated a movement towards the modern Napoleon and the Napoleonic Code, an instrument for the political transformation of Europe. It's like a story, you have to go through it. Like, I just cannot rush through and give you question answers. If you come to know about it, any questions comes to you, you are going to hit it there only and you will get marks right there. So you have to write, you have to understand. So if you once understand it, like watching a movie or listening to radio or something which you hear by constant, with your mind into it, you'll obviously get it into your head. So my type of teaching in history or SST, rather SSC, social sciences, is that I take it very slow, part by part, because history was not created in one day or in one period. So history was a long period of time, it takes time. You know, we have short movies, we have video movies, we have commercial movies of 3 hours or 2 point something, you know. So we go through that. So we cannot take a commercial movie to a video movie or a video short movie on YouTube or on Netflix or anything like that, right? So we have those quotes. A serial cannot be a movie. A serial is part by part. So we have to go with that. That's the way I go, you know. It might be boring, but at the end of it, it's very interesting. Okay. So what happened is during that time, what was I saying? Yes. The nationalism across Europe with the radical intellectuals were influenced by Napoleon. Now, who was Napoleon? That's a question. Napoleon Bonaparte, born Napoleon de Bonaparte, was a French statesman and military leader who became famous as an artillery commander during the French Revolution. He led many successful campaigns during the French Revolutionary Wars and was the Emperor of the French. So everyone got up from ground level zero. So he was just a statesman, a French statesman. He was from the state. He was just a normal person and a military leader. He became that, and who became a famous as an artillery commander. Artillery is of gun shooting, artillery, you know, they have heavy machine guns, heavy artillery is about firing. And artillery, we can say it was with also bow and arrows, but during his time they didn't have bow and arrows. They did must have been having, but artillery was all about gunpowder and shooting. During the French, he led many successful campaigns and he became very famous, and he had that gesture in him and the Napoleonic code. What is the Napoleonic code? French code of Napoleon, officially Code Civil de Française, referred to as Code Civil in the French, civil code established under the French consulate in 1804. That was the Napoleonic code, you know, officially Code Civil de Française, civilians, for the civilians, as an instrument for the political transformation of Europe. Its twin ideological goals, nationalism and revolutionary armies, carried the slogan liberty, equality and brotherhood. French for liberty, liberté, égalité and fraternité is French for liberty, equality, fraternity. It is the national motto of France and the Republic of Haiti, and is an example of a tripartite motto. Although it finds its origin in the French Revolution, it was the only motto among others and was not institutionalized. Okay, so that is the liberty, equality of brotherhood which came into this revolution they were wanting, and the ideas of liberalism. What is liberalism? Is a political and moral philosophy based on liberty. Okay, so that is actually, it depends upon people's views. And when you are liberal, when you have liberty, liberal espouse a wide array of views depending on their understanding of these principles, what actually they are. But they generally support free markets, free trade, limited government, individual rights, is called liberalism. And self-determinism, he argued that the sense of nationality was the cement that held modern societies together in the age when dynastic and religious allegiance was in decline. In 1815, at the end of the Napoleonic Wars, the major powers of Europe met at the Congress in Vienna. Okay, and the Congress of Vienna, and tried to restore the old dynastic system as far as possible, ignoring the principle of nationality in favor of legitimism. Now, what is legitimism? Legitimism is if I go to say, legitimists are royalists who adhere to rights of dynastic succession to the French crown of the descendants of the eldest branch of the Bourbon dynasty, which was overthrown in 1830, July Revolution. They reject the claim of the July monarchy of 1830 to 1848. Okay, this is all about it, and my time is also going up, and I'll see you. Take care of yourselves. I'll see you again on the next class. So today is Wednesday. I'll see you tomorrow, Thursday. I'll see you on Friday also. So every day I'm going to put up videos for you, for your SST. And hope to see you soon, guys. And take care of yourselves. Bye-bye. I'll be uploading till where I told you today. I'll be uploading notes also for you guys. Thank you. Take care. Stay home. Stay safe.